Hello, Victoria. I'm Ellie.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. We're the Fan Carpet. We just wanted to ask you a few questions about judging the Golds Movie Award.
Yes, very excited. It's an amazing event and what a beautiful cinema to be in.
You know this is the oldest cinema in the UK?
I do know. Yeah, I've always wanted to come here and I'm really glad. I've been looking up the images on Google. It looks stunning.
It's an absolutely beautiful building and it's got so much history.
Beautiful, isn't it? Yeah. It was silent films.
Yeah, it started with the Lumiere brothers. Yeah, I think they're going to do a little speech about that before.
Very good. Exciting.
Absolutely. So what was it like to judge the Gold Movie Awards?
It was a privilege. I got to see such good work. I was so impressed. Because, you know, you often get asked to do things and, you know, you think, oh, are they going to be good? And I was blown away by the standard. The production values, the talent, the writing, the acting.
How was the sound? That always lets down independent film.
No, the sound was good. No, I thought, you know, the quality, I don't know, I feel very excited about the film industry and independent film at the moment, and I think we're just seeing so much great films coming out. Like, it's very, and all these films, these people are ones to watch, and I can't wait to meet some of them and congratulate them, really.
Oh, that's so exciting. Was there one film in particular that stood out for you?
I really liked a film, it was short, called The Overcoat, which it's a very quirky concept, and they really went for it 100%. And the look of the film, it's quite stylized and a bit like Amelie, like the kind of colours that they used. But it was really original and just beautifully shot. The art production, everything on it, I thought was fantastic.
So that was a clear winner for you.
I really loved that film. Yeah, I did.
I can't wait to see it. How long was that one? Was it about 20 minutes?
Yeah, 20 minutes, I think. Yeah,
around that. Do you judge many movies?
I haven't judged before, no.
Yet, yeah.
I know, yeah.
So start as you mean to go on. What are you working on at the moment?
Well, I've got a film coming up, an indie, and then another short, a really good short, and then I start Fantastic Beasts, so.
Well, that's a nice lineup to have. What would you say the main difference, apart from the money, between working with on independent film and a big commercial film like Fantastic Beasts is?
So, well, the difference, obviously, budget. But, you know, it's a very, everyone working together. If you're doing a film like a million budget, then there's a lot of passion, creativity, and people are there because they just love the script and they want to do such good work. So it's got like a let's all do this together, whereas obviously Fantastic Beasts with that kind of budget, it's a very well-oiled machine, and there's a particular way of how everything is. It's very, you know.
You know your shoot days, you know. You have a trailer, someone making you coffee.
Exactly. Yeah, those kind of things. But yeah, which is lovely. But no, I mean...
The indie films keep you grounded, obviously.
Yeah, keep you grounded. But I think, but also it's what you're an actor because you love to be creative. So, you know, everyone wants... I mean, I've read such incredible scripts lately. I've been up for lots of amazing scripts written by women, directed by women. Really young, exciting, fantastic directors. And I think it's an exciting place to be. I'm glad, you know, I'm getting to be part of it.
Oh, absolutely. I couldn't agree with you more, because it's going into a different era.
I do, and I think like more of the general public are being exposed to independent cinema because of Netflix and Amazon, and so they're watching films you never would have watched because it's accessible, and also there's more money therefore to make more indies, and you've got a platform to show them on, and like Hulu and all these different things. It the breadth just means that there's more diverse work being made, and it's obviously good for it, the industry.
Absolutely, and if you have a story to tell and a burning passion to tell that story, you've got, like you said, a platform now to put it out there. And I think the Gold Movie Awards is another area that people can do that too.
Absolutely. I want to sit and go through all of the films that, because I really was impressed, and I think a lot of the people, especially with the shorts I saw, are going to go on and do fantastic things, and a lot of them look like they could be turned into features and were, you know, of that standard.
Do you have any passion yourself to make a short film of your own?
I am actually making one.
Tell us more. Can you tell us anything about it?
What would I say? It's kind of like Naked Lunch-esque. Joe Dorowski-esque.
Did you write that?
We're in the process.
In development.
Yeah.
And is it a all-female strong leads?
It would be me, and then a few other people. But I suppose it's the kind of film that I'm really interested in, which is why I'm making it. So it will be quite avant-garde.
Oh, I'm excited! I'll definitely watch the space for that. It's been an absolute pleasure to meet you. Enjoy the Gold Movie Awards. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching The Fan Carpet. If you like this video, be sure to click that thumbs up button at the bottom of your screen. And also be sure to subscribe to The Fan Carpet YouTube channels. They're absolutely free and so much fun too. Be sure to check out the official website, thefancarpet.com. Also, you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram to stay up to date with reviews, competitions, the latest news, and so much more.